Home. Messaging. Proceed southwest on Coyle Avenue in 241 feet. Turn sharp left to East Pacific Coast Highway. Home. Messaging. Proceed to route start at East OST. Attention, a new important message has arrived. Home. Messaging. Enter trip vital in 60 seconds. Proceed southwest on Coyle Avenue in 245 feet. Turn sharp left to East Pacific Coast Highway.
Ready to go. enough power cables overhead?
Attention, a new important message has arrived.
Go back to the truck stop, take a nap, clean out the trailer. Emphasis on take a nap. But they're still squirrely about if it's going to be ready tonight or if the shipper is not got the product ready. But we'll have to see. See how it goes, you know by now. We never know what we're doing until we're actually doing it. Right?
I-710 North and Long Beach Freeway North. You on 2 I-710 more. Proceed north on I-710 more in 2.25 miles. Stay left to continue on I-710 more. 2 miles. Continue straight on I-710 north. Continue straight. Stay left for I-105 East. Continue on to I-105 East. Continue straight for I-6, 05 north. hit you on 2, I-605 north. Continue on 2, I-605 north. Gradual spin. Half rate 100 feet. Stay right. 4. California 60. Pomona. And Pomona 3.
See my blinker. Doesn't mean speed up.
on Pomona Freeway. Thank you. 2 miles. Take exit 40 on the right for Milliken Avenue and CA-Farr Avenue.
Look at this corner, the San Antonio Winery. San Antonio. San Antonio. So we're gonna come in here to the truck stop, park in the fuel island, get coffee while send a message. And while we're waiting for a reply to our message, we're gonna get coffee. And that will determine our next step. I am reckoning or suspecting that we will actually go head over to the truck stop, or not truck stop, washout. We're gonna trailer wash out today instead of messing with tomorrow or later tonight or whatever. I don't know what we're doing. So just hang on tight. First things first, gotta put fuel inside the trailer. We can drop this trailer at the next shipper. The next load's preloaded.
Continue straight onto South Milliken Avenue.
I really don't want to pick up at 10 o'clock tonight, but I got to see what the plan is. Look at the mountains, you can barely see them. They're there, but they look like they're a ghost. Ghost mountains.
In 2 miles, continue straight onto North Milliken Avenue. Then, after 94 feet, turn right to East Guasti Road.
Glad the sun's out though. Look at these nice palm trees in front of the Toyota plant. I like palm trees. Who's gonna wash my trailer out? Them are long-legged palm trees. Skinny and tall. But I'll take all the pine trees in the middle. I like pine trees. But they don't grow in clay soil very well at all. They're like sandy and loamy. Beautiful day in California, doodah. It's a beautiful day in California. Thank you.
continue straight on to North Milliken Avenue, then turn right. Proceed east on East Gawasti Road in a quarter mile. Look for your destination on the left. I-10, exit 57, Milliken Avenue.
So like I said, we're gonna pop in here and see if we can't put fuel in the reefer, get coffee, and get to the trailer washout. Maybe get some answers. If you lose your ticket here, it costs you $100. It's like it only costs $20, so if I lost my ticket, that means I pay for 5 days. Wow, all the fuel out. Pick a spot and wait. Hey, look at Super gave me $5. Thanks for the coffee there, buddy. Hey Lionel, how you doing? Bunny Fox, bringing donuts and tacos. Hey Jude, hey Pete Tubbs. Well, I would back up, but there's a truck like literally an inch from my bumper, so we better not back up. See me through the reflection of the doors. No 34 hour restart. We ain't doing that. Oh yay, this dually just comes flying behind me. Now I want to know why in the world people do that. You see a truck backing up with its flasher lights on, and you're going to run and squeeze him behind while he's moving. I love it. Alright, well.
Attention, a new important message has arrived.
Dispatch figures out what they're gonna do. We're gonna go get a cup of coffee. so is it gonna let me get fuel here or what? You know what? Obviously, the weekend crew is not interested in doing their job. They're not activating the next trip. I can't get fuel for this trip until they do. So, Merry Christmas, let's have a commercial. And then, I guess we're gonna go to the trailer washout, see if they'll... Because we need a trailer washout, period. Trucker app so that I can find the address.
Home. Messaging.
Where do we need to go?
Messaging.
All right, let's go. We know we need a trailer wash, so let's go get one. We'll worry about fuel later. Well, the most important thing about this stop is getting coffee. And coffee will tide us over through the fueling process for the trailer and, of course, waiting in line at the washout.
new message has arrived. A new message has arrived. A new message has arrived.
You approved the trip and everything after we leave the fuel line. Yeah. Good, smooth move. That's okay. We'll just have to come back. It feels pretty nice out here. Nice California sun. Sunshine in my eyes. You see my blinkers on. There we go. Somebody saw me and flash your lights. That's good. Most of the time, the trucker puts their lights on or their signal on, and the four-wheelers all think that that means, hurry, we're 3 miles behind him. We better mash the gas just so he can't get in front of us. And you think I'm kidding? And Jemima! Cherry Avenue. I remember when this intersection used to be a skinny one lane, I believe, ramp. And I always hated using this ramp. We completely rebuilt this bridge. Made it tons wider, twice as wide, I think. Hopefully there won't be a big line. What? 5 new messages. See, look at that. Car, truck, whatever that is on the left. That yellow sticker. That means a mashup. Y'all can get your very own mashing sticker in the Big Rig Travel store.
Dispatch, South J9478.
Three Sisters truck stop, woohoo! Oh, you're gonna let me... There we go. I've not ever been to this truck stop. I'm glad to remember this one.
Destination is on the left.
prepaid parking, of course. Maybe truck stop. Hey, look, nobody's in line. That's a trailer washout. Woohoo! This is good service right here. Well, I have to remember this place. Hopefully, we gotta go pay. Hopefully you guys don't overheat. Sitting in the sun, we'll be right back. Okay, $36. That's my copy, that's their copy. Wash out the scale. Ah, me oh my oh, me oh my oh. Okay, so okay. Can I take a bun? Yeah. There you go. All right. Now. Now, back to the truck stop for fuel. I was hoping to get fuel while we were there. See you flying up behind me, let's go. Thank you. moved, they moved over. So I started to move over, and then they darted back in my lane. It's like, well, I was already halfway there. You know what I think? I got a hunch. Hunch. I got a hunch. I think we're going to head to the shipper immediately after fuel. In case the trailer's ready early. Which I have a strange, wonderful feeling this might be. That miracles do happen. Y'all don't mind hanging out with Big Rick Steve today, do you? Who yelled at you? So, trivia question for you guys. On a trailer door, such as a trailer in front, we are given seals. Now why didn't you just take the other lane? On the, like, on a regular trailer, truck trailer, you have a left door latch and a right door latch. You get one seal What door do you put the seal on? Do you put the seal on the left door, or do you put it on the right door? I'll check out some answers when I stop. Now all we're going to do is put fuel in the trailer, because our next shipper has the trailer preloaded, which means we're going to be dropping off this empty. No customer will let you drop an empty reefer unless it is topped off full. So we'll be right back. I see a lot of good guesses. I see one nerd guess. Alright, so if you guessed the right door, your answer would be right. If you put it on the left door, you could actually open the trailer doors and never cut your seal. And yes, I have seen that on more than one occasion. So kind of mutes the point of having a seal on there. So why do we put seals on trailers? So the shipper knows that we didn't touch it, and the receiver knows that we didn't touch their stuff. It protects the driver from, if you're coming up short on cases or something like that, nobody can say you stole it, especially in high dollar meat loads and whatnot. But now we have a clean trailer and we have a full reefer. So we are all set to head to the shipper and present our trailer to them. If our trailer is ready, we'll pick it up. I don't know how many hours we have to roll, not that much. I doubt that it will be ready early, but I don't know. I've never been to this place before, so I don't know what their MO is. If it is not ready, then we'll just drop the trailer, sit there and bobtail, and sit on their property. Sometimes when you do that and they know you're waiting, they go ahead and load you up early if they got manpower and the ability to do that. So you never know. Figure it don't hurt to try. In fact, if you want, one time I did that and the guy says, well, we could load you early. I can't remember where it is, somewhere in Massachusetts. So they said that we could load you early, but it won't be for like another 2 hours. So they said, if you want to go ahead and put it in the door, you can. So we put it in the door, and I noticed across the street was a big old pond or a big old lake or whatever. So I asked him, I said, will you call me if you need me? Can I go play over at that lake? And they said, that's a good idea. So we did. We spent several hours over there, and I have pictures of my little side adventure while we were being unloaded. in the photo gallery, look under U.S. photos, then look under the state of Massachusetts, and it's like maybe the only gallery I have in there. It's called Rose Lake, I believe, or Rose Pond. Actually, it was one of those hidden gems that I didn't think it would be much, and it turned out that I was just having a good old time exploring. And to me, that's what truck driving is about. If I'm not driving, I want to get out and play. Photos will have a date on it, but I want to say it's like dang 6, 7, 8 years ago when I first started. I might even have the date on the gallery. The gallery listed or something. I don't remember exactly when. But time and places all run together for me. Just because we go everywhere. Alright, so we stay in the green arrow. Stay in the green arrow. Mash it! Yeah, let's just... Yeah, that's it. Little Toyota. But I had a real good time. When I was out snooping around there, I actually found, I believe, an old military base or fort or something. Never figured out what it was, but it was like, it had footprints of a bunch of buildings, and I think somebody somewhere told me it was an old military base. Robin's Pond in Devens, Massachusetts. That's exactly right. Oh, do I want north or south? I want south. I want here. Stay here! Okay. Slingshot. I tell you, them things are up. They really are. A backwards motorcycle may be okay, but I just don't. A slingshot just does not look right. Almost caused an accident with that truck. That guy's really good. And they're about to do it again. Somebody needs to fire that McKinney driver. Almost take us out. Almost take the other guy out. I think he's in too much of a hurry to be truck driver. I think we're only going 1 mile to the next exit. Riverside, man. East Riverside. When was the first one or the second? sky don't look near as hazy as it did yesterday. The perfect hiking weather, perfect lounging in the backyard weather with the barbecue going, swimming pool parties, any road crew with a swimming pool and a barbecue and a steak. Sunshiny days like getting somebody. I don't know what he did, but the cop just pulled out of the thing, turned his lights on. He's going to get somebody. Is it a chase? Is it a chase? Because that guy's in the hammer lane and not pulling over. Woohoo! California chase. Come on! Let's catch up. We don't check the suspension. That cop's still chasing that guy. I don't know if it shows up on camera. By the way, I said this earlier this morning, I'll repeat it for the afternoon folks. If you have ordered something from the Big Rig Travel store, you did not get an email. You should have, but you didn't. There's a glitch on the email that I'm working with. However, I did see your order. I I did see your order and it was shipped out and all this other stuff. Everything worked properly except for you just didn't get an email. That is being worked on. So just wanted to let you know in case you were wondering. Guys didn't know it, You can make easy peasy donations to the website, keep the cameras going. If you have PayPal or actually any credit card, simply type in BigRigTravels.me/PayPal. I don't know. I screwed it up. I lied. All right, here we go again. Take two. PayPal.me/BigRigTravels. And that goes into the Big Rig Travels website fund. Keeps the cameras going. Pays for hosting and all sorts of other things. Come on, I'll let you over. There you go. This year, 2018, is when I renew the hosting, and we just bought a secure certificate and a bunch of other things, so our cost now is going up to about $600 a month. So it is expensive to do the website. This BigRigTravels.com website and all the included travel and chat and good times, all for free, anybody who wants to view it. And it will always remain free.
Exit on the right,
4
California 60 East,
3 large shirts left of the previous Big Rig Travel shirts, the red Peterbilt on the white shirt. We only have 3 left. Those are out of production, so if you want one, you better get it. Only 3 left. They cannot be back ordered.
Stay right, 4 I-215 South and San Diego.
wonder if we could pop down to San Diego real quick and come back.
Proceed south on I-215 south, in 5 1/4 miles. Take exit 2-3 on the right, 4 Harley Knox Boulevard.
Brake check! Moreno Valley. I just figured out why that's a familiar name. That's a place, in fact, this road right here, Alessandro, is a place that we made the delivery that says, you're not allowed to park on our property. But you're not allowed to park in the street. And you're not allowed to park in the dirt lot across the street. So it's like, where in the world do you open a park? And when I asked them that, they raised up their hand and they go, I don't know, I'm just telling you the rules. Like, well, you kind of don't make it easy, do you? Travels, a million miles of America. By the way, that is a real possibility to happen one day. I've looked into it over the years. I would love to. A nice leather-bound hardback cover, hardcover, 100-page, 11 by 17, I believe, coffee table book. Tons of photos and whatever. My printing cost for that was $200. And I thought, ain't nobody gonna want to buy it where I even make $10 each. March Air Force Base is on our left, and it looks like they're having an air show. I don't know. But it looks like I see tons of people and tents and lots of airplanes and people walking around their airplanes. Maybe is there a airplane show here? And with this traffic here, that just might be. Yeah, they're doing around. Cool beans, I want to go play. I wonder if I can ride my Segway over there. Can you see these airplanes on the left? Probably not. Thank you. they're having a big old air show up there. I was gonna say, I hear sirens. Well, there goes the fire truck. See a missile over there. Yeah, look at all the people parked on the shoulder over there on the right hand side. They're watching the air show. Man, this is a humongous air show they got. Look at all the people over there. March Field Air Museum. Tons of people out and about. Cool beans, they're having a dog chase. Man, look at all them old airplanes. Maybe we'll sit at the shipper and I'll bring out my big old camera and with the zoom lens and try to capture some of these. And I don't know, but I'm going to take a wild guess that we probably don't have a good signal out here, because this air show with all these people and all this traffic, everybody's probably doing Facebook pictures or whatever and overcrowding the towers that are here. Y'all drive instead of looking at the airplane. We have a car that is driving on the shoulder, the right shoulder. I would assume he's trying to get around me, but he's not speeding up. He's staying exactly by my side. So I don't know what he's doing. problem is. Yep, cool looking air shoulder there. I didn't know that. Alright, so we are basically where we need to go for our next shipper. I don't know if it's going to be ready early. I don't know if it's going to be ready on time. I don't know if it's going to be ready late. So I don't know what we're going to do. So just enjoy your afternoon, and if we happen to roll again today, we'll start broadcasting and y'all will know about it. And if not, then we'll roll tomorrow morning. So in the event I don't see you guys, make sure you have a wonderful Sunday afternoon. And thanks for choosing Big Rig Travels to take you across the country. Nobody probably heard that.